Roberts of Roberts CPA Group. Window World, my friend Kim Foster, make sure that you contact her if you need windows, siding, garage doors, roofing, whatever your needs are for a home. I bet she can take care of you. And then About Face Bond Salon, who make you beautiful inside out.
Not all financial advice is crystal clear, and even the pros often disagree about what course of action is best in different circumstances. That's why the best financial advice is traced back to the fundamentals, the basics, uncomplicated nuggets of wisdom that seem intuitively true. For example, Mom always used to say, money doesn't grow on trees, and she was right. Of course, Mom wasn't being literal. Like so many other pieces of advice from Mom, this was more symbolic. She was saying that money doesn't come easily, so you must protect it, keep it safe, and don't waste it on frivolous things. Hi, my name is Kevin Roberts from Roberts CPA Group, and today I want to help you protect your money so you can find the financial freedom you've been working so hard for. That's why I put together a free resource that lays out some of the most valuable pearls of wisdom from someone we all looked up to. I call it Lessons from Mom, Motherly Advice on Health, Wealth, and the Pursuit of Happiness. And I want to offer this special resource to you absolutely free. To claim this free resource and start putting your money to work for you and gain the financial freedom you're after, simply request it online at robertsfreereport.com. Again, visit robertsfreereport.com.
I love sharing all of my tips with you, so I'm going to share this one with you ladies and gentlemen who would like to look younger. About Face Bond Salon has a microcurrent facial that is amazing. It helps to firm, tone, and tighten. It re-educates your muscles. It really does. It helps remove blockages on skin and gives a more even tone and a beautiful complexion. You call them and get an appointment with Tia and get a discount and tell them Just Ask Joyce sent you. 812-288-2300. Shakes and Scallops, roofing, shutters and gutters, soffit and fascia, vinyl sidings, doors, and yes, windows. Along with their attractive merchandise and professional installation, they also have an incredible peace of mind lifetime warranty. Yep, from the date of installation, Window World will be there to service any defects in material or workmanship. Now that's the kind of people I love to deal with. Call Window World today at 502-671-7777, 671-7777, and visit their website at windowworldlouisville.com.
Not all financial advice is crystal clear, and even the pros often disagree about what course of action is best in different circumstances. That's why the best financial advice is traced back to the fundamentals, the basics, uncomplicated nuggets of wisdom that seem intuitively true. For example, Mom always used to say, money doesn't grow on trees, and she was right. Of course, Mom wasn't being literal. Like so many other pieces of advice from Mom, this was more symbolic. She was saying that money doesn't come easily, so you must protect it, keep it safe, and don't waste it on frivolous things. Hi, my name is Kevin Roberts from Roberts CPA Group, and today I want to help you protect your money so you can find the financial freedom you've been working so hard for. That's why I put together a free resource that lays out some of the most valuable pearls of wisdom from someone we all looked up to. I call it Lessons from Mom, Motherly Advice on Health, Wealth, and the Pursuit of Happiness. And I want to offer this special resource to you absolutely free. To claim this free resource and start putting your money to work for you and gain the financial freedom you're after, simply request it online at robertsfreereport.com. Again, visit robertsfreereport.com.
Just Ask Joyce, where real life and family values connect. Hosted by author, speaker, and minister's wife, Joyce Oglesby. If you'd like to ask Joyce, call 571-2428. That's 571-CHAT. Ask a question, share a story, and preserve the faith.
Wanna leave a legacy? How will they remember me? Did I choose to love? Did I point to you enough to make a mark on things? I wanna lead it all for a child of mercy and grace who blessed your name unapologetically.
And welcome to Just Ask Joyce. I was thinking we were going to play the whole song, but we are going to do that. Gary has the entire Legacy song pulled up, and we are going to hear that today because that has been the mantra of my show, actually, since I have begun.
Yeah.
And, if I have done anything in the, I've been in this ministry now for 12 years. I've been on radio for 9, right at it. And if I have done anything successful at all in this ministry, it is prayerfully to let you understand how important your legacy is. And prayerfully, you have come to grasp that vision of not just mine, but of the Lord's, because I believe God wants us all to deepen and steepen our legacy and to preserve that legacy. That has been something that has been so important to me. And I just pray that, you know, that you are going to keep that in your hearts, in your heads, in your spirits for from now until Jesus comes back. You know, I've kind of built you up today, and if many of you have followed me on Facebook, you have understood that there was a big announcement coming today. If you have been listening to me with intent ears, and I always tell you, you know, all these Family Life Fix-It Pro tips that I've given you, I've been telling you to listen, you know, husbands, I always tell you that about your wives, right? But we all should listen to people because there's a message behind their comments many, many times, whether we're listening for Christmas tips, you know, about gifts or whatever. But there's usually a message hidden beneath and in between the lines. And I've been trying to kind of prepare you this week for today, which is not an easy day for me, I can tell you. And I don't know if it's going to be an easy day for you or not. I guess we'll just have to see about that. But this is the last live show of Just Ask Joyce on WFIA. I don't tell you that with, you know, an eager heart at all. It is with a heavy heart that I share this news with you. It is not because I have decided to step down. It is because the new ownership of this station and the other stations of Salem here in the Kentuckian area has decided that, you know, I'm not a fit for their new plans. And that is why I am stepping aside. And this will be my last show on WFIA. Again, live. Now, we're going into the new year and we have some holidays, and so you'll hear some best ofs. But come January the 3rd, the Just Ask Joyce show will be no more on WFIA. All right. Now, that does not mean that I am going away forever. I want you to understand that. I am not going away forever. God has, He has really put this on my heart for a reason. I stepped out of a court reporting career that, you know, was a very comfortable career actually for our family. And, you know, I had really made a mark, I think, in the court reporting world because I trained over 300 people, men, mostly women, but a few men, to be court reporters. And I did that gratuitously. I did that, you know, because I believe that God gave me the skills and I wanted to help others. And so I've always been a helper of people. I knew that God had laid that on my heart at a very young age. That if I could ever, if he would just spare me from, you know, what was happening in my childhood, that I would serve him forever. And I think I've really gallantly given it my best effort in whatever profession I've been in. The court reporting career, you know, in the ministry with Webby, and now, you know, the Beyond This Point ministry that I have been a part of now for 12 years. It's been my ministry, and that will carry on. Now, I've been preparing you to make sure that you go to my website, that, you know, you will find out what's going to happen to Just Ask Joyce from there. She's going to be around, as I said. I'm going to be your Family Life Fix-It Pro from now until Jesus comes back. If you need help in any area, I hope you feel comfortable calling me, even though, and that's, you know, yesterday I gave you my cell phone number. Remember that? You know, the pieces are starting to fall together, aren't they? Right? I've been, you know, pushing you to my website. I've been encouraging you to follow me on Facebook. I've been encouraging you to follow me on Twitter, you know, all those things so that you will know what is happening with me. Encouraging you to write me justaskjoyce@gmail.com and send me your questions. I will start blogging after the first of the year, and, you know, and I may use some of your questions with your permission, and we will have a Q&A exchange there. I'm hoping to do some podcasting. That's kind of, you know, I'm looking at a lot of things. This has been an abrupt news to us, okay? We've only had a few days to digest all of this as well. So this is not like this has been planned for, you know, 6 months and you're just hearing it at all. This is as much news to us as it has been to you. Just, you know, we've just only had a few days. You know, it came just before Christmas. And so, you know, we've only had a few days to process it all and I waited until today to just share that, you know, this would be my last live show. So make sure that you, you do all those things. And I'd love to hear from you today. I would love to hear from you today. If you want to come, I didn't plan a show at all today because I just would love to, talk to my listening audience, by phone. If you want to call in and you have anything to say, or, if I can help you with a problem, I'm still here to do that. But if you have anything at all to share, you feel free to call in 571-2428. Now, remember, I am giving away books again today, all right? So Gary will be taking your number if you would like. This is why I was telling you, I see all these hints I kept giving you. I have 3 days that you can get a free JJ book. And so this is your opportunity. If you don't have one of my books, you call and I will autograph you a free book. I will mail it at my expense to you. Keeping His Pants Only Till He Gets Home, or Grandma's Jewels. So those are the two books that I'm giving away. Make sure that you give me a call and, tell Gary, and I will make sure that you get those books in the mail very shortly. I did not have a chance to call everyone yesterday. We had a wonderful night with some friends last night, and so I did not get around to calling, but I will make sure I do. Debbie, how are you today?
I have a very heavy heart.
Oh, so do I. So we're in the same boat.
So do I.
And Webby's here too. I haven't really said Webby's here, but he's my support guy. So anyway, he is here.
Hi, Webby.
I wanted him to be here for the, the sign off on WFIA. So,
well, I have to tell you, radio has been so lucky to have someone like you. And I have a heavy heart, not only for me and for you, but for all the people who don't have access to the internet or don't use the internet.
I know. I've thought about that. I'm like, and that's why I gave my cell phone number out, Debbie, yesterday, because I know that some people don't, they don't do internet, and so it's important to me that if they need me, that they can contact me. Usually people do have, a phone access, so they are, more than welcome to call me, on my private cell phone number. So,
yes. So I wanted to make sure that all those people listening that do not have access to internet, please jot down Joyce's phone number, please. Because you have made such an impact on this community. I have listened to you practically every single day driving home from work. And even when I come home, I turn the radio back on just to listen to you for the next hour. It's been such a blessing. And I want to thank you so much. I use my gift card to About Face yesterday.
All right.
About Face Spa. And
good.
I got the facial, the microdermal.
I told you it was going to be good, didn't I?
It was really good. Wonderful.
Yeah, those gals are great. They've been a wonderful sponsor of Just Ask Joyce. They've been behind me, since it's been a while. I mean, almost since they took over the business at About Face, they, sponsored me pretty much right away. And they have just been a godsend to me. So, I'm just going to encourage people, the sponsors that you've heard on the show, just let them know. Listen, whenever you have an opportunity to use them, they've been faithful to me. And you remember them whenever you have a need, whether it's, Robert CPA or Window World or, About Face Spa and Salon, Squire Boone, all the ones that have supported me. And so God bless you, Debbie. Thank you so much, sweetheart.
No, God bless you. And I will see you in Corden.
All right.
At Webby, I will be listening to Webby too, and you will hear from
all
me.
All right. All right.
From your phone and on the internet.
All right. God Thank bless you, you. Thank you so much, guys. We'll be back. 571-2428.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Hey, this is Kevin Roberts from Roberts CPA Group, here to talk to you about football and retirement. The draft is a lot like planning for your retirement. You do your homework, make your investments, and you hope they pay off in the end. But if you haven't created a playbook with the right strategies to play both offense and defense, then you could be losing out on time and money. Do you have a coach in your corner with the right tools and strategies to guide you to victory? In fact, that's what I wrote about in a brand new special report I created just for you. It's called Kickoff to Retirement, and it focuses on the essential draft picks you must consider before and during your retirement. What I want to do is this. I want to get this special resource into your hands for free. To claim this free resource, simply call 426-0000 or visit us online at smartmoneycpa.com. When you do, my assistant will have my calendar open, and you can claim a free one-on-one session with me to review your current strategies and create your financial game plan. Again, to put your money to work for you and gain the financial freedom you're after, call 426-0000 or visit smartmoneycpa.com.
Quality of life is something we all strive for, living your life the way you want. At East Point Audiology, they truly believe that hearing leads to a better life. Audiologist Melanie Driscoll has a patient-centered approach focusing on satisfying your hearing care needs. Hearing happens in the brain. Connections happen in the heart. East Point Audiology provides hands-on, personalized care that will diagnose and find solutions for your hearing and balance needs because the focus is entirely on your unique needs. Going to East Point Audiology means that you will experience patient care that is specific to you with exceptional follow-up care that ensures your individual hearing and balance needs are met. East Point Audiology wants you to be satisfied with your care. Their services are fully guaranteed. Schedule a free consultation today, which includes screening. Experience the latest in technology that will fit you perfectly and renew your world of hearing. Call East Point Audiology at 502-548-0589. Online at eastpointaudiology.com.
This Christmas, give the gift of family by supporting Focus on the Family.
The holidays bring families together. We help keep them together.
Right now, your tax-deductible gift will be matched by a grant to double your impact. It's a great way to say thank you to Focus for all they've done for you and your family.
Just log on to our station website and use the keyword family.
Just go to WFIAFM.com and enter the keyword family.
Hi, I'm Don Crow. Join me this weekend for The Christian Outlook. We cover everything from the Bible and theology to politics and the persecuted church, all the stuff that matters each and every week. Hear from newsmakers, Christian leaders, voices you can trust. Join me on The Christian Outlook.
Stay informed with The Christian Outlook, Saturday mornings at 7 on 94.7 FM WFIA, The Spirit.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining me today. This is a farewell show on Just Ask Joyce. This is, as I have been telling people, if you've just joined us, this will be my last live show on WFIA. You'll hear some best ofs in the next couple of days until January the 3rd when the new ownership takes over. And, I just was sharing with the audience that, we just kind of found out about it ourselves. So this is not as much a surprise to us as it is to you guys. But the new ownership did not see fit to bring along Just Ask Joy. So I am saying farewell to you only on WFIA, but not forever. I will be around to be your Family Life Fix-It Pro for as long as you need me. And you will have to access me through my website, justaskjoyce.com, my Facebook page, of course, Just Ask Joyce. And I'm going to give you my cell phone number. So if you have your phones or your pens, I'm going to give this to you as well, 812-989-8175. That's 812-989-8175. And thank you for calling, Garrett. We'll get to you in just a second. I got Ann on the phone. Hi, Ann. How are you?
Well, I'm gut punched. I'm actually shaking because I was standing here doing my kitchen dishes, and I thought, oh, great, I can listen to all 2 hours of Joyce, and I'm shaking. I mean, I'm shocked. I feel like I've been hit in the stomach. And I was listening to what you said at the beginning. You said, if you have done anything successful in your ministry, if, and I'm just thinking, she is an advocate, a champion for families, individuals, whether they're married, single, with or without kids, I mean, seniors, young people, middle-aged people, and upper middle-aged people like me. I'm just shocked. I mean, you're an advocate, you're a champion, and most of all, you're bold, and you're just unashamedly, unapologetically in battle for his cause. And this is a tremendous loss. I can't believe it. It's a huge loss for everyone who has listened, for the people who will never get to hear. And it's clear to me that whoever decided this is out of touch with listeners of WFIA. I mean, your biblical wisdom, the election selection, the national people that you've had on your show, I'm just shocked. And I'll stop talking because I feel like I'm going to cry.
Aww.
But I just thank you for coming into my life through the air. I wouldn't have gotten to know you and your wisdom and just learned so much and deepened in my faith had it not been for Just Ask Joyce and for Joyce Oglesby. So I thank you, and I will listen to see what they think they've got that's going to be better than this. And so I may not be listening much longer to the channel, but I'll be curious to see what the powers that be decided. But I will definitely take your number down, and we will be in touch.
Oh, God bless you. Thank you so much.
Joyce. Thank you for your sacrifice and for your mentoring of total strangers and for people such as myself who have called every now and then with a problem. You've just been so compassionate, but you've just been spot on and accurate and just so you just shine for the Lord. I mean, you're the crowns in the jewels in your crown are just, I can't imagine how heavy they are for your little neck. But, I love you, and carry on, my sister.
Oh, you're sweet. Thank you so much, Ann. God bless, and you stay in touch, all right?
I will. Yeah, thank you.
And Garrett, thank you so much for calling. There's only one Garrett.
Well, thank you for taking my call today, and it is. It's a heavy day. It's been a heavy few weeks for the two of us.
I know. I'm so sorry. I know they lost you, and now they're losing me, so I hate that.
Well, but I want to thank the members or the listeners of Just Ask Joyce for calling me and for emailing me and texting me these last since the last One Nation on 970, mm-hmm. and, of course, again today. And I'm just so proud of what we did with election selection.
Yeah.
I feel like we brought, and Ann just mentioned it again,
mm-hmm.
and I feel like we brought such unique perspective. And if we did have a victory this year, I hope that it is that our country just turned around. And I pray for President-elect Trump and Vice President-elect Pence, and I ask our listeners to continue that. And to know that we aren't going to end our advocacy for election selection or wherever Joyce goes, and even on her website, I'm here to give advice and here to give advice to any of you if you have any questions.
Oh, well, Garrett, thank you so much. I mean, you know, it was a unique year for Just Ask Joyce on Wednesdays, and I just loved the wisdom that you brought, and you exactly, you know, what I wanted to convey to the audience to be informed, educated, and prepared. I believe that you fit the bill, and you really launched us into a different path, I think, and about thinking about who we are voting for and why and the reasons behind it and all. I mean, you just really brought a whole different perspective to many of us. So thank you so much for your loyalty, and you know, and it was a sacrifice on your part. I didn't pay you to come over. I didn't have any money to pay you, you know, so, but you just did that willingly, and it was awesome, and it did not go unappreciated, I can tell you. So God bless you.
And yours did not for me either, and I appreciate, again, you and love both you and Webby, and I love all the listeners, and I know that bigger and better things lie ahead for all of us.
Well, yep. God bless you. God has
Garrett.
A plan. Yep, he has a
Thank
plan,
you.
And we'll be here to serve. So
How's
God bless
mom
you.
Feeling, by the way? Garrett?
He's hung. All right, God bless you, Garrett. Thank you so much. All right, guys. You know, if you're just kind of tuning in and you're wondering what these calls are all about, you know, this is kind of a farewell show to you listeners from me on the WFIA network, because it has undergone new ownership, and you know, the ownership has decided not to bring along Just Ask Joyce, and so this is kind of my farewell show. You'll hear a best of tomorrow, and then again on Monday as we go into the new year celebrations. It's kind of why I did the ABC resolutions for 2017.
Right.
See, it's all the puzzle pieces are fitting together now. And I so desperately did want to share that with you, you know, as soon as I found out, but I couldn't and did it, and I respected that. But I did drop a lot of hints. I dropped a lot of hints. But, you know, this has been an incredible journey. I loved, you know, WFIA and all that, you know, I embraced here. And all the new friends that I have met because of my experience here at the station. Of course, you know, even, you know, the personnel here, but the listenership. And I have a plethora of contacts on my phone that, you know, have some of your names by it, because many of you have been mentored by me. You know that. I, you know, don't have to share that with anybody because that's between me and you. But, you know, many of you have been mentored in some capacity. I hope that Duke and Emma are listening. I don't know if she is. I know that Duke is probably maybe working, but I'd love to hear from them. If they are, and I know, you know, that's a long shot, me throwing it out there. It could be one day that she's not, because she usually is.
We'd love to hear from anybody.
We want to hear from anybody. You know, I'd love to hear from you, and you know, just to say goodbye. I mean, basically, yeah. Because I pray that our paths will meet again. Listen, we are going to, Webby and I are going to be doing the Romancing the Rock, More Than a Dream. That's February the 10th. And you can go to Marriage at Mercy, and that is Mercy with an I. Now, not a Y. If you go to Y, you're not going to find it, all right? Marriage at Mercy with an I. .org, and you can sign up. We'd love to see you there. That's going to be a great celebration. Would love to have you here. All right, my sister is on the line. I see. Hi, Kat.
Hey, Sissy.
Hey, girl.
Hey, Kat.
Well,
hey, Webb.
I'm losing some listeners in Georgia. Even, you know, I mean,
yes,
I
have all the way down to the Florida state line.
That's right. That's right.
I just want to tell you how proud I am of you. I think I've been your number one fan besides Webby.
Besides Webby.
Yep. But I just want to say, if I can, maybe they won't cut me off, but I just want to say they are really losing out on a great ministry that you have just given to everyone 100%, and they're really going to be losing out. And most of all, your listeners are going to be losing out.
Yeah, I know. I hurt for them, but, you know, God has plans, and I'll be there for them. I love you, sis. God bless you.
Thanks for calling, Kat.
Guys, 571-2428. You can call. We'll be back.
WFIA, The Spirit.
8 years of earning the Good Housekeeping Seal? 8 years. That's nothing to sneeze at. 0% financing is something to take special note of as well. Superior Products, low pricing gives you an advantage of renovating and or building your dream home. With windows, doors, vinyl siding, and roofing, Window World's online design showcase is easy to navigate, and in the comfort of your own home, you can choose style and color options, grid and cut glass styles. Call Window World today at 502-671-7777, 671-7777. You know, I've been talking about Spalding University Center for Behavioral Health. I've been building up, guys. You see, you're going to need someone to help you with your family relationship issues. Of course, I'll be around, but Spalding University, they're the professionals. They have a team that is there waiting for you. Low to no cost, high quality assessment and treatment. You don't have to wait. You can just call and book an appointment immediately. Whether it's marriage and relationship issues that you're dealing with, if you have grief that you are trying to struggle through, don't struggle anymore. If you have some addiction that you've been battling for years, why would you not call Spalding and get help? Let's go into 2017 with a better attitude about life, because life is too precious to ignore, that you can live it better. All right. Spalding University Center of Behavioral Health. Their number is 502-792-7011. That's 792-7011. Or go to behavioralhealth.spalding.edu.
Hi, this is Steve Arterman. Join us for New Life Live each weekday. Real people, real issues, and real answers.
I've been listening to you for about 4 years, and I've been blessed richly.
He is one of many people that we deal with here. Broken, twisted, disturbed.
How can I disagree and not be disrespectful?
When the Bible talks about repentance, it's not, okay, I'm sorry, I won't do that again.
Yeah, that's what I got.
Right, and people get fooled by that all the time.
New Life Live, weekday afternoons at 1 on WFIA, The Spirit.
I've heard that when one is having a difficult conversation with another person, The best way to get them to listen to reason is to season your words with a bit of flattery. Now, I'm all for showering others with praise when it is appropriate and well-deserved, but I would not recommend flattery as a means to an end. However, I would recommend what Paul suggested in the book of Colossians: season your speech with the salt of grace, and not just a little. Graceful and kind words will go a long way toward helping two people find the common ground they're searching for. And this is David Jeremiah, encouraging you to get on the road to new life. Discover God's gracious words on Route 66.
Route 66, driving the word home. Log on to Route66Life.com and get your roadmap for life. That's Route66Life.com. Route 66, start your journey home today.
The real estate market is hot right now. Are you thinking of buying or selling your home in this market? Do you have any questions about preparing your home to sell? Are you even thinking about real estate investing? Do you have questions about financing a piece of property, or should you refinance your current home? Let me assist you in all of your real estate needs. Hire the hardest working real estate agent you'll ever meet, Elizabeth Monarch with Keller Williams Louisville. When the time comes to making that important decision of buying or selling your home, call me. I want to be your realtor. Search for All Homes at ElizabethMonarchGroup.com. Like me on Facebook. That's Elizabeth Monarch with Keller Williams Louisville at 502-551-1286. ElizabethMonarchGroup.com. The hardest working real estate agent you'll ever meet.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining me today. This is the farewell show of Just Ask Joyce, if you're just tuning in at the bottom of the hour. I'm saying goodbye to WFIA listeners because we now have new ownership that will be taking over January the 3rd. And as I have said, they have decided that JAJ does not fit their format. So I will be moving on, but not moving out of your lives. All right. Want you to get your pen. I will be giving my cell phone number to you again. I've been doing that all week. I've been giving you little hints. And, of course, you know, you can stay in touch with me at my website, justaskjoyce.com, or my Facebook page, Just Ask Joyce. And, Stuart, thank you so much for calling in.
Yes. I want to give a testimony to the new owners. I was in bumper-to-bumper traffic. I wanted to die. My sin was that great.
Aww.
And I was channel surfing. I heard your voice. I heard your sincerity for God and your love to help people. You changed my life. You took me under your wing. You showed me that I was not out of the reach of God. I love you, Miss Joyce. Thank you for saving my life.
Thank you, Stuart. God bless you. You know, I pray for you every day. And, you know, it's no mistake. God networks in great ways. But I'm not out of your life. Remember that, all right? So I'll be praying for you, and I'll be, you know, we'll be mentoring more. So you just hang in there because, you know, you're important and you're special to God. You know that.
Thank you.
God bless you. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
All right. Bye-bye. Ah. Those are reasons why my heart's heavy today. Steve, thank you so much for calling in.
Hey, Joyce. So sorry to hear, but I know, this, you've changed radio stations a couple of times, and boy, there's just no doubt that I'm sure you're going to be back somewhere else real soon. You've just got too much of an impact and too much of a ministry to be held down.
Well, thank you, Steve. I appreciate that. Yes, and you know, I mean, you know, if God's not done with me, he's going to land me somewhere, that's for sure. And that's why I just tell everybody, you know, just to go to my website. I'll be posting things. There'll be, you know, updates on me, and we'll make sure that everybody's kept abreast of where I am. Because I don't think he's done with me yet.
Oh, I don't think so. Right. And, you know, you're going to have mine and my wife's prayers and wishes with you. And I know good and well the Lord is not done with you yet.
All right. Thank you so much. And thanks for being a faithful listener. God bless you.
Thanks so much. Bye-bye.
All right. Bye-bye. Okay. Duke and Emma, we're listening. Duke, Emma, do I have both of you?
You have both of us.
All right.
Hello.
Hey, y'all.
I'm telling you. This is a great reunion. It's a wonderful reunion. Oh, well,
yeah,
you know,
it's so sad why we're here, you know.
I know. But, you know, listen, God kept me long enough here at WFIA to save your marriage. Not that
That's
I saved
right.
it, that he did, you know, but he just used me to do that. And I, you know, I told you guys many, many times, and if you're new listeners and you don't know who Duke and Emma are, I can tell you we mentored their marriage right here on air for right at a year, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. And I mean, and it was on the rocks, man. It was wrung out. And you know, you guys, the next step was divorce for you. And here you are. You celebrated your 15th. Have you already done 16 already, or is it coming up?
We did 16th on December 2nd.
Yes, yeah. I thought so. I thought, because y'all have yours just before mine and Webby's.
Right.
I remember that. And sorry I didn't send you congratulations, but that 16 years, and I mean, how grand that was. But you guys were just amazing ministry on Just Ask Joyce. You were the ministry, not me. I want you to understand that, because you example to people how God can and does restore marriages, because he did. He did.
Absolutely. We both just love you, and it's so sad that we're not going to get to hear you now, and so glad that, you know, God put you in our lives, because we wouldn't be together if it wasn't for that, you know. Mm-hmm.
I know, and your kiddos love it too, don't they?
Oh, they do.
I know. You got mom and dad intact, but you know what? I'm not gone forever. I don't know where God's going to put me, but I'm not gone forever. So you guys, keep in touch. It's time for us to do dinner again, for sure.
It is.
Well, God love you.
And we love you.
I love you too. And thank you so much for being a part of this ministry and how you ministered to many couples. Love you so much. God bless you. Guys, we'll be back.
Love you. Thank you.
WFIA, the Spirit.
'Tis the season, and Heitzman Traditional Bakery and Deli is ready for your Christmas and holiday parties. With complete dinners available for your gatherings, order yours today. Of course, Heitzman has so many other reasons to stop by. They're the home of the famous Butter Kuka and delicious homemade strawberry or blackberry jam cakes. For 125 years, Heitzman is the bakery that says, yes, we can. Ask about catering. We're open 7 days a week on Shelbyville Road near Hurstbourne. Call 426-7736.
Reality shows, they are the rage today. Flip through the channels on Primetime Tonight and you'll find them everywhere. What's the attraction? They're live, they're real, and you just don't know what might happen next. Hope in the Night with June Hunt is a reality show too. Live, real, with unexpected twists and turns in the stories of real people facing real problems. June unravels the initial story and reveals the hidden mysteries of causes and characteristics of the real problems facing her callers. But unlike other reality shows, Hope in the Night provides biblical hope and practical help. Why should you listen? Because when the people who call in to Hope in the Night share their stories, they are often your stories or the stories of people you care about.
Join June Hunt for Hope in the Night, tonight at midnight on WFIA The Spirit.
If fish could walk, this is Ken Ham, an Aussie transplant with a passion for God's Word and the Gospel. You know, for a long time, the fossil Tiktaalik has been claimed as evidence of fish evolving into amphibians. Now, evolutionists have always thought that the front fins of Tiktaalik allowed it to walk on land. They believe these fish evolved four legs later. But the recent discovery of well-preserved rear fins has changed things for evolutionists. One professor now thinks fish evolved to walk before they left the water. Of course, creationists have argued for years that Tiktaalik likely had a rear fin to help it swim. But it's a huge jump to think that these fish used their fins to help them walk on land. Tiktaalik was clearly just a fish that could swim really well. The difference between land animals and fish? Well, it hasn't changed.
Want to learn the true history of creation and about the full-size ark we're building? Visit our faith-defending website at answersingenesis.org. Answersingenesis.org.
Ancient flavors, fresh ideas, Yankee Noodle.
Wait is over.
Yankee Noodle is now open in the Highlands.
Create your own custom stir fry
with the ingredients and sauce of your choice.
Located in the Highlands at the corner of Bardstown Road and Baxter Avenue.
With walk-up service available.
Dan and his staff invite you to experience the same ancient flavors and fresh ideas
that's earned Yankee Noodle the best takeout restaurant in Louisville for the past 3 years.
Three locations.
Oxmoor Mall, Middletown, and the Highlands.
Ancient flavors, fresh ideas.
Yankee Noodle. You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA. The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining us today. It is a farewell day on Just Ask Joyce. It's not something that I had planned on. You know, we think about that, Webby, and yeah. You know, we were just lobbing along last week, just, you know, happy-go-lucky and thinking everything was, you know, I'd planned out shows for, you know, the next on into the next month. And you know, and all of a sudden we get a call and Salem's sold out and we have new ownership. And I mean, everybody, a lot of people's world turned upside down in, you know, just a single phone call. But, you know, God knew all of it anyway. He knows everything. He knows exactly what's going to happen. He's in control, not us. And we just have to trust him.
That's
with
right.
our lives. And, you know, I hate it for the listening audience that this is not, you know, they're, you know, this is the last opportunity that they'll have to call me on air. But
right.
it is not the last opportunity that you have to call me. All right. And I'm going to keep stressing that because and I'm not a glutton for punishment. Just understand that I'm not a glutton for punishment. You know, I spend a lot of hours mentoring. A lot of hours. And, of course, it's, you know, it's a ministry. You've been to me. I don't charge you. Some of you have been to me. I don't charge you for mentoring. I just mentor because, you know, I have a passion for the preservation of families. I think that God laid that on my heart with my books. And again, if you don't have my books, I'm giving two away today. You can go to my website at any time and get my books and I'll, you know, you can get it. But I'm giving two away today, the Keeping His Pants Only Till He Gets Home and then Grandma's Jewels. Those are the two I have, you know, more of a plentiful nature of. But anyway, if you don't have one, I would encourage you to call and give Gary your number and I'll call you back. But would love to hear from you today if you have listened to the show and you want to say goodbye. This is a perfect opportunity for you to do that. Hi, Dee. How are you?
Hey, honey.
Yes.
I had to call in.
Yes.
I can't believe it's your last show. And as I've told you, I know God's got awesome plans for you and you're going to keep going. And I'm excited to see what's going to happen and how he's going to, I lost the word. He's just going to take this and you're going to soar into something else.
Well, we'll see what he has planned. I don't know. It's always interesting when you're dealing with the Lord. That's for sure. You know, you never know.
I'm just so proud of you and so proud. I love the fact that I've got to witness this with you and watch you grow. I've known you since your first radio show. I might have probably called into that one, and so I had to call into this one.
Yeah, I was thinking that you possibly did. Yeah.
So I just want to say I love you, and I'm so proud of you. And I don't know. I can't believe that this is happening. It makes me sad, and I just know, though, that God's going to use it, and he's going to take you places.
Well, thank you. Just keep me in your prayers, all right?
Always.
All right. God bless you. Thanks so much, Dee. Appreciate it.
Love you.
Love you. All right. Yeah, I think she called on the first show. And,
yeah, I believe she
did.
How
befitting that she would call on the last one. But anyway, but again, you know, we don't know what God has in store, but I will, you know, I'm looking at podcasts. I'm looking at television. I'm looking at a lot of things right now. So we'll see. Lyndall, how are you? All right, hold on. I think Garrett's got to patch... All right, Okay, here we go. Who is it? Who do I have? Lindell. How are you?
I'm well, Joyce, and yourself?
I'm just doing well. Thank you.
I wanted to thank you for just what you do on a daily basis from Women's Choice. I mean, you just had excellent people on, just like Dr. Bourne.
Oh, yes.
We would have not known
but for,
without
yeah.
you. Mm-hmm. And he literally has changed our life and as well as my family's life. And I just wanted to, I told Gary I didn't need to be on the air, but thank you so much for everything that you've done and just staying the course.
Thank you. Dr. Bourne was scheduled. He's taken a hiatus a little bit because he was moving and in that transition. And he was scheduled to be on the show today. And then I had to bump him and I said, you know, I'm not selfish very often, I can tell you. But this is, I just had to be selfish today and, you know, abscond with your show because this is my last day. And he's like, so I'm not coming on. And I'm like, no, Andy, you're not. I'm sorry. But, but thank you so much, because I know that people will remember that Andy was such a critical part of this show too, because he brought a lot of insight about health and answered a lot of questions. And so he was a big part of Just Ask Joyce as well. So people are going to miss those kinds of things. Yeah.
Yes. I mean, it was just that you consistently had just outstanding people on that, just like with the food and water for Haiti, that we don't have to do the background, or I never felt like I needed to do the background check or do anything to look into it. If you had them on, I just trusted that because you always said you had prayed over, you know, what you do. And I know I'll miss you.
Thank you so much.
Very much for all that you've done.
Oh, well, God bless you. That means a lot for me, Lindell, that you would call in.
Yes.
Really does. Thank you so much.
Yep. Have a great day.
You too. All right, John. All right. We appreciate it. And bring Ann on in. Listen, Ann just called and she's in the lobby. She came up. She's like, she just wants to be here and be supportive. And I'm like, sure, bring her on in. It's fine. I could have invited all of you.
Yeah, we
could
have
had a big old party like we did at the Haiti, the food for the poor thing. And that was a glorious celebration. And, you know, and I will still be very involved in, you know, in a different capacity with food for the poor, because I did believe in that. I went and saw what they did and loved Food for the Poor, fell in love with their ministry even more than I had before, because I had done my homework. Lindell was right. I had done my homework, and Food for the Poor is a legit operation, guys. And I can tell you, I pray that you will continue to give to that operation. Can I just say that? And if, you know, I'm not telling you have to, or, you know that. But if you're going to give, would you consider just continuing that ministry with Food for the Poor? Because I know what they do with their money. I've seen it. And lives are being changed and impacted on a daily basis. It's not a one-time shot, guys. It's not we give money and they go and help. This is a daily basis that they are helping people. And so I just would pray that, you know, if when you get information from them, you feel compelled to keep giving it, not because Just Ask Joyce is pushing it, because your heart for them is in place, because you were introduced to it maybe through Just Ask Joyce. But they are a legit organization, and I love them, and I stand behind them, and I've already let them know that, hey, I'm on board with you guys. So just know that, they'll have my support, and I pray that they will continue to have yours. We're going to come back. This hour is already over.
I know.
I only have one more hour with you after this. So if you want to call in, feel free to. And I'm happy to give you some books. Anne is here. She's not happy.
I
know. You're still shaking.
I'm
sorry. We'll be back. 502-571-2428. Call in.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Introducing the right way to market your home. Reflections of You by Amy. Here's award-winning designer and certified expert psychological stager, Amy Wagner.
That certification that we have has trained us to know the emotional triggers that pull a buyer into your property or push them away from your property. We have a 98% success rate. Trust us, we have got the plan. And even in the middle of winter, we are selling homes within 30 days. We have been at Homerama for the last 4 years. We would like to bring our furniture from Homerama to your house and create a showcase listing. A vacant house is a stale house. No one wants to visit a home that is empty and try to imagine where they're going to put their furniture. We can take care of all of it for you. We have the painters, the handyman, the flooring. We don't stage it and leave it. We stage it and market the property.
Get it sold now with Reflections of You by Amy. Online at amywagnerdesigns.com or call 384-3660.
Choosing the right school for your child can be one of the most important and difficult decisions you can make. WFIA wants to help make that decision a little easier by inviting parents and guardians to attend the 4th Annual School Expo at the Mall St. Matthews on Saturday, January 14th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. The expo will feature local, private, and independent schools. Take advantage of this opportunity to talk with representatives from some of Louisville's top schools. Explore the variety of faith-based and independent private schools, interactive displays, all in one convenient location. WFIA, along with sponsors Class Act Federal Credit Union and Black Diamond Pest Control, look forward to seeing you at the Mall St. Matthews, Saturday, January 14th, starting at 10 a.m. For more information on participating schools and sponsors, visit our website at WFIAFM.com and click on the School Expo banner. And if your school would like to participate, contact Stephanie at 502-423-3135.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining us today. It is a farewell day on Just Ask Joyce. And, you know, I don't like saying goodbye. I'm not saying goodbye forever. You understand, just on WFIA, I will not be on this station any longer. It has new ownership as of January the 3rd, and they have decided that I am not going to be a part of their format. That, hey, that's life, isn't it? It's their choice, and they get to make the calls. If I'd had control of it, I'd done things differently, but I don't. So there you go. But we do know who is in control, and that is God. And Rue, thank you so much for calling in, sweetheart.
Hi, Joyce. This is indeed a sad day for your listeners. You're a prime example of how God uses people. You're a transcender, one who has risen above a very terrible childhood, and God has used you to help people from all walks of life. You have an innate ability, Joyce, to listen and to evaluate the situation and come up with a godly response and godly advice. And that's very special. I feel like you are so spirit-filled. I mean, God has just used you, and I don't think he's finished with you. And for your listeners who haven't really maybe been listening closely, the number of men that call in to talk to you is incredible. Men don't do that, but they trust you, Joyce. Mm-hmm. And they're going to be lost, because I've listened to talk shows who help people, and they don't have the male response that you do. I mean, you have people from all walks of life, but I find it especially interesting for the males who call in and trust you and pour their heart out to you. Mm. So I know that God has a plan for you, and I know that it's a plan that will glorify him even more than you have previously.
Oh, thank you, Ruth. That means a lot to me. You know, I mean, you know, what you say is true about the men calling in. It's always amazed me, but I have said many times, I am a champion of men. You know, I have every reason not to be, but I am, because God restored that trust, not just, you know, in men, but he gave me a trust in him and, you know, proved that if I just trusted him, he could take me places that I would never go, and, you know, led me right to, you know, the arms of a man that has loved me, you know, unconditionally. And so, you know, and it could have been a totally different picture, but it wasn't, because I trusted God. So thank you so much for those kind words. I really, really appreciate it. You just have no idea how much that means to me today. So God bless you. Thank you so much.
We love you, Joyce.
Thank you. Love you, too. And I'm going to give my number again. So that you can write this down, because if you, I am going to be your Family Life Fix-It Pro. I'm not, that part of me is not going away. And so if you need me at any time, after today, or, you know, maybe it's next year, you put me in your contacts. You never know when you're going to need someone. And so you put me in your contacts. 812-989-8175 is my cell phone number. 989, that's 812. It's an Indiana number. 989-8175. It is on my website. You can go to my website, justaskjoyce.com. I'd encourage you to like my Facebook page. I'll be making posts there as well. I don't, you know, of course, won't tell you what's on topic for the show on WFIA, but, you know, I don't know where God's going to lead me. As I said, I am, you know, talking podcasting. I'm talking television right now. I don't know. We'll just see. So, you know, he knows, and Webby and I are just going to trust him with that.
Yeah, and y'all need to remember, her passport over the bridge into Kentucky does not expire this year.
That's right. I still can drive. And Kristen, we've got just a moment here before the next hour. Thanks so much for calling in.
Hi, I just wanted to call and on your last day and tell you how much I love you and how proud I am of you. And as Alex and I today celebrate our anniversary.
Aww. I was there. I was there.
I know you were there, and Webby married us.
Yep.
It's like, that was so cool. Another Georgia listener, by the way.
Yes.
That's right. Well,
yes, I'm going to miss being able to listen to you every day from Georgia, since I can't see you very often.
I know. Well, thank you so much. You know, you have been a faithful listener, even in Georgia, and it's just, that's just so cool that you would take the time to call today. I'm sorry that you had to learn like this, but anyway, it's, you know, a lot of people are learning for the first time today. So God bless you, though. Thank you so much, sweetheart.
Thanks,
we love
Kristen.
You.
Thank you. Love you.
All right.
Love you.
All right, guys, we are headed into the last hour of Just Ask Joyce on WFIA. Who knows what God has in store from here on out? But today, I say goodbye to you listeners on WFIA. So make sure that if you would like to call in next hour, you will. In the meantime, I'm in battle for his cause.
The Spirit 94.7 WFIA FM New Albany Louisville is a service of Salem Media Group, online at WFIAFM.com.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Wally Hines. President Obama's imposed sanctions on Russian officials and intelligence services in retaliation for Russia's alleged interference in the U.S. presidential election. The State Department also has kicked out 35 Russian diplomats from their embassy in Washington and the consulate in San Francisco, giving them and their families 72 hours to leave the U.S. Russia has suggested it could retaliate against American diplomats, and a foreign ministry spokeswoman says Russia is, quote, tired of lies about Russian hackers. Parts of New England gearing up for a nasty nor'easter.
As the storm does deepen, we're going to see increasing winds. So along with the heavy snow, there's going to be blowing and drifting of snow. Again, anywhere from eastern to northern New York and into central to northern New England.
The National Weather Service's Bob Orovec says some areas could get a foot or more of snow. The Syrian government says it's on board with a Russian and Turkish announced ceasefire set to begin in about 1 hour.
In a statement, the Syrian army said that it should pave the way for reactivating negotiations to end the conflict.
Correspondent Vladimir Isichenkov in Moscow. Vladimir Putin says the ceasefire will be guaranteed by the Russian and Turkish governments. Also at SRNnews.com, Russian investigators are close to ruling out at least one possibility in the crash of a jetliner into the Black Sea.
So far they're saying it definitely wasn't a bomb. There was some kind of a recording of what was going on in the cockpit that they said indicated some kind of what they're calling a special situation. They haven't elaborated to say exactly what that means, but we certainly know that the pilots knew that something was going on with the plane.
Correspondent Kara Rubinsky. Todd Fisher says the final words from his mother were, "I want to be with Carrie." Legendary actress Debbie Reynolds died yesterday. just a day after the death of her daughter, Carrie Fisher. More on these stories from townhall.com.
WFIA, The Spirit.
It is the 4 o'clock edition of Just Ask Joyce, and as you well know by now, it is a very special day on JAJ. I want you to make sure that you stay connected with me. Facebook, of course, is one avenue. You can like me there. You can follow me on Twitter. You can also access my website anytime, justaskjoyce.com. That is justaskjoyce.com. And, of course, if you have a relationship problem, always feel free to write me, justaskjoyce@gmail.com. justaskjoyce@gmail.com. I will always be here for you. Always. And you can count on me. I am still going to be in the ministry of helping people. So make sure that you stay connected with me. Now, this hour is brought to you by Window World. And if you need something done to your home, windows, doors, garage doors, windows, whatever, you make sure that you call Kim Foster and About Face Bond Salon. They are always all about you.
Watch thousands of music videos from your favorite Christian music artists anytime you want at GodTube.com. Jeremy Camp, Hillsong, Casting Crowns, and Chris Tomlin.
Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow.
Visit the all-new GodTube.com. The best Christian music videos, family entertainment, and more. All free. GodTube.com. That's GodTube.com.
By now, everyone knows Class Act Credit Union offers some of the very best rates on auto loans. But the savings go way beyond low interest rates. Many lenders charge application fees, credit fees, and prepayment penalties. But not at Class Act. And you'll save even more on related products like gap and extended warranty policies. Best of all, you'll get personal service from friendly, knowledgeable people. Ready for a new car? Apply online at classact.org today. Class Act Federal Credit Union. It's like straight A's for your money.
Quality of life is something we all strive for, living your life the way you want. At East Point Audiology, they truly believe that hearing leads to a better life. Audiologist Melanie Driscoll has a patient-centered approach focusing on satisfying your hearing care needs. Hearing happens in the brain. Connections happen in the heart. East Point Audiology provides hands-on, personalized care that will diagnose and find solutions for your hearing and balance needs because the focus is entirely on your unique needs. Going to East Point Audiology means that you will experience patient care that is specific to you with exceptional follow-up care that ensures your individual hearing and balance needs are met. East Point Audiology wants you to be satisfied with your care. Their services are fully guaranteed. Schedule a free consultation today, which includes screening. Experience the latest in technology that will fit you perfectly and renew your world of hearing. Call East Point Audiology at 502-548-0589. Online at eastpointaudiology.com.
This Christmas, give the gift of family by supporting Focus on the Family.
The holidays bring families together. We help keep them together.
Right now, your tax-deductible gift will be matched by a grant to double your impact. It's a great way to say thank you to Focus for all they've done for you and your family.
Just log on to our station website and use the keyword family.
Just go to WFIAFM.com and enter the keyword family.
When's the right time to take on codependency? What about depression, anxiety, and grief? You see, Valley View Church's Celebrate Recovery is more than just a 12-step recovery program for alcohol and chemical addiction. It's a meal, testimony, and support through accountability. Celebrate Recovery breaks down into smaller groups by gender while we work through life's hurts, habits, and hang-ups. And yes, there's childcare here, too. Join us Thursday evenings at Valley View, and let's tackle a problem or two. Visit vvchurch.org.
I don't mind if you got something nice to say about me. I enjoy an accolade like the rest. And you could take my picture and hang it in a gallery of all the who's who's and so-and-so's that used to be the best at such and such. It wouldn't matter much.
Okay, and now you know why that has always been my theme song. I just want to carry on God's work, but I want to make sure that I stand before Him and He says, well done, well done. I love the part in the song that says, I'm not well-to-do or well-bred. I'm like, that is me, you know. But it doesn't matter from where you come. It doesn't matter. You can be the most ordinary person in the world, and God will use you if you allow Him to use you. And you can create a legacy. You know, it doesn't matter how your legacy starts off. And I think that has been maybe a signature of my ministry, is because, you know, I didn't have a very good legacy to stand on until a Gideon put a Bible in my hand, and it changed my life forever. It changed the course of my path forever. But here's the thing. Just the Gideon putting that Bible in my hand was not all that it took. It took me making a choice to choose Christ, to follow Christ, to trust Him. The Bible didn't make the difference. The choice made the difference because I had the Bible. All right. I'm not saying that the Bible doesn't make a difference. It does, but you have a choice. I mean, a lot of people read the Bible and they don't get the same, you know, they don't make the same will. They don't have the same path, and make the same choices that I did. And so I know how much the Bible can change a person, because it changed me and my legacy. And then, of course, you know, Marion Webby and our legacy, you know, my legacy changed at that moment. And so now, you know, we've been plowing through our legacy for almost, you know, working on now 46 years, baby. Yeah. We just celebrated our 45th. And, you know, so now, you know, we're looking at how we're passing it down to our girls, and they're passing it down to their children. And, you know, that's what it's all about, guys. And that's been the heart of my ministry here on WFIA. I've been involved in my ministry, Beyond This Point ministry. And now, you know, Beyond This Point, that was exactly, you know, when God threw that book in my lap, and that began my ministry, keeping his pants on until he gets home. You know, that really, you know, I knew that Beyond This Point had to be what I would name my ministry, because he really got me beyond a point of, I felt like, no return.
Right.
And, you know, and Stuart called in the first hour, and that's him. You know, that's what he was saying. It was beyond, he was at a point of no return, he felt like.
Yeah.
But, you know, God had different plans.
Yeah.
For
are
that.
You going to let the 4 o'clock group know what's going on?
Well, some of them are just, I had to give them time to get in the cars.
Oh, okay.
I knew what I was doing, baby.
Oh, okay.
I know my audience. But anyway, it's okay. It's all right. But this is my farewell show, and that is why you heard the entire legacy song. And we'll see if we're still getting phone calls. We've gotten a lot of phone calls during the first hour. You know, we may play that song the last segment as we sign off. But I certainly want to have time to say I'm in battle for his cause one last time to
one
you.
One more time.
But for WFIA listening audience, this is my last time that you will hear me live. Now, a couple of days, you'll have some best ofs, but this is my last live show. And, you know, it's just the way it is. There's new ownership that has come in, and, you know, they bought out Salem stations, and WFIA is part of that. And the new ownership does not see fit to, you know, to bring me along with them. And so I will not be a part of your listening enjoyment from now on WFIA. Don't know where God will land me. I believe he'll land me somewhere. So you can follow me and keep up with what I am doing. I will always be your Family Life Fix-It Pro. I've given you several hints over the last few days. Listen, this is a real new shock to us too. So, you know, it's not like we've known it for a long time and we're just passing it on to you. It's fairly new. Takeovers are kind of just that. They're quick. But I've been preparing you, but I want you to remember that I will always be your Family Life Fix-It Pro. If you need me today or you need me a year from now, I will be around in some capacity. I don't know where God will land me, but he'll land me somewhere. And I'm going to give you my cell phone number. I've been giving it for the last 3 days, if you know, and I'm also giving away some of my books. If you would like one of my books, you be sure, if you've been thinking, oh, I should do that, well, today's the last day on WFIA that you'll be able to do that. So you make sure you call Gary, give him your number, and then I'll call you back and get your address, and I'll get you a book, Keeping His Pants On and or Grandma's Jewels, in the mail to you. But Tracy, thank you so much for calling in. Appreciate it.
Joyce, I'm just heartbroken.
I'm sorry. I know. I am too.
I looked so forward to getting in my car at 4 o'clock for the last 6 or 8 months, and now it's like, really? I just can't believe they would make that decision.
Well, you know, I don't know what's in their minds, and, you know, but it remains to be seen, and I'm sure that God's got it all in control, and it's going to just, you know, it'll work out to be what it's supposed to be, and we're just going to make the best of it, right?
Well, but, I just want you to know you are truly a blessing.
Well, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. I've tried to always make sure that I didn't waste God's time on this air. I know
you
we had some lighthearted days. When I think about, you know, the lighthearted days that we had during the December days, I'm like, man, you know, that might be, I don't know if it's a regret or not, because I had so much fun doing it, but I thought, man, that might have been, if I had known, you know, that I had such limited time with you, I might would have been more serious, because family
is serious. I think God has giant plans for you.
Well, thank you so much, and I can't wait to see what it is, Tracy, but you guys keep up with me, justaskjoyce.com. On my Facebook, the Just Ask Joyce page, and I will keep, you know, I'm always going to be there. But y'all send me questions if you have relationship issues at justaskjoyce@gmail.com, and I'll be there for you, all right?
I'm going to miss you. I'm going to show up one day at church for webbing you.
All right. I'm going to expect that. We'll give
that.
Our address.
We'd love to have you.
All right. And we
John,
have John holding. John, we're going to a break. We'll be back after this short one. Don't go away. Farewell day for Just Ask Joyce.
WFIA, the Spirit.
Ancient flavors, fresh ideas. Yankee Noodle.
The wait is over. Yankee Noodle is now open in the Highlands.
Create your own custom stir fry
with the ingredients and sauce of your choice.
Located in the Highlands at the corner of Bardstown Road and Baxter Avenue.
With walk-up service available.
Dan and his staff invite you to experience the same ancient flavors and fresh ideas
that's earned Yankee Noodle the best takeout restaurant in Louisville for the past 3 years.
Three locations.
Oxmoor Mall, Middletown, and the Highlands.
Ancient flavors, fresh ideas.
This Christmas season, your family will celebrate the birth of Jesus and all that it signifies. With a nativity scene, glowing stars, statues of the Magi on your mantle, and hanging lights that signify one of the most important events in world history. How would you like to see with your own eyes those very places that thread the tapestry of the Bible? Experience Israel next fall, and for 9 memorable days in November, immerse yourself and explore the places you've read about for years. Let the Bible come to life in the Holy Land in 2017, all during the 50th anniversary of the city of Jerusalem. During this important season, while you visit with loved ones and exchange presents, consider a decision to unwrap a gift next year that is sure to be life-changing. For more information about Experience Israel 2017 and to register for this trip, visit WFIAFM.com. That's WFIAFM.com, keyword Israel.
Reality shows, they are the rage today. Flip through the channels on Primetime Tonight and you'll find them everywhere. What's the attraction? They're live, they're real, and you just don't know what might happen next. Hope in the Night with June Hunt is a reality show too. Live, real, with unexpected twists and turns in the stories of real people facing real problems. June unravels the initial story and reveals the hidden mysteries of causes and characteristics of the real problems facing her callers. But unlike other reality shows, Hope in the Night provides biblical hope and practical help. Why should you listen? Because when the people who call in to Hope in the Night share their stories, they are often your stories or the stories of people you care about.
Join June Hunt for Hope in the Night tonight at midnight on WFIA The Spirit.
This is Hugh Hewitt for the TownHall.com Weekend Journal. In a fast-paced world, you want more than just facts. You want insight on the news that's shaping the world around you. Get It from Bill Bennett, Mike Gallagher, Dennis Prager, Michael Medved, and me. I'm your host each week on the townhall.com Weekend Journal. Give us an hour, we'll give you all the week's events from a perspective you can trust.
Stay informed with Town Hall Weekend Journal, Saturday evenings at 8 and Sunday afternoons at 4 on AM 900 WFIA, The Spirit.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining us today. It is the farewell day of Just Ask Joyce. Not that I wanted to say farewell, but, you know, there were other plans in motion, and I didn't have any control of it. But it's not the end of Just Ask Joyce. I want to remind you to just follow me on Facebook and go to my website. I will be starting to blog and keep you informed and, you know, try and give you some family nourishing ideas and, of course, answer questions for you as well. We have John on the line. John, thank you so much for calling in.
Hey, Joyce. Hey. Webby.
Hey, how you doing, John?
I'm doing okay. We're one of your biggest fans, Francis and I.
Aww.
It was really great to see you the last time we did. I know it's
right.
been a little bit, but it was good to sit down and have a little chow. I think it was a little while ago that it's
yeah.
been, but
you guys have been listening.
Sad to hear the news today.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
Well, you know, God has done many, many things in you guys' life, and he is... He's shone a light that has spread. I'm getting choked up. Sorry.
I know.
You guys have spread that light to me, my wife, and our extended family as well.
So. I know. Well, thank you. Thank you. God bless you, and thank you so much for being so
yep.
loyal.
Keep
love
me in
you
your
guys.
Prayers, buddy.
yep. Love you yeah. guys. It's all right.
Love y'all.
All right. Valerie, thank you for calling in.
Hey, Joyce, I just wanted to let you know that I'll miss you profoundly. You've just been such a blessing and encouragement in that 3 o'clock and 4 o'clock hour for me and my nephews on our drive home from work and school. And you're just such a blessing, just such an amazingly generous person and giving. And I know God has good things in store for you in 2017, but we sure are going to miss you.
Oh, well, thank you so much, Valerie, and I will you too. And you just keep me in your prayers, but also you stay in touch with me on those outlets that I have, and you know we'll see where God takes me.
But all right, Joyce. God bless you.
God bless you. Thank you so much.
Bye bye.
All right.
We have a special guest in the studio.
We do. I know. Tom Mitchell. Now, I have the best of I can't say both worlds. I mean, because I don't want to exclude you, baby. But, you know.
Well, that's all right. I've been excluded before.
I've got my two favorite producers right here.
That's right.
Tom Mitchell, guys. You remember Tom started me off.
Yeah, yeah. I was the first guy.
You were the first guy. That's right.
And now you got the best guy in there. Now you got Gary.
Now I got
so
Gary.
You got the first and the best.
I know. It's just, I mean, I talk about shocks when Tom Mitchell came in with Orchid in hand. I'm like, okay. I mean, it was just a pleasant surprise. And of course, his beautiful wife, Robin, is here. And, but anyway, and we've, you know, I kept saying you had these magic hands, you know, because you and Robin are quite the act anyway. And of course, maybe you guys have heard them at some of the events around town, but
I hope so.
Yeah.
I know. Plug yourselves. May as well.
Well, we're playing at the Wick's Pizza in Middletown tomorrow.
There you go.
Cool.
Come on out, 8 to 11.
There you go.
All right.
Overreactors, right?
Overreactors.
That is correct.
That's mm-hmm. right.
Yeah.
All right, Mary, thank you so much for calling in.
Hello, George.
Hey, Mary. How are you, sweetheart?
I'm doing good.
Good.
I'm going to miss you.
Well,
I've known you for over 5 years and hearing you, but... And it's heartbreaking that you have to move on, but I know God has another plan for you.
I know he does. And you remember us breaking some Chick-fil-A bread together, don't you?
Yes, I do.
You had never eaten Chick-fil-A. I was giving away some Chick-fil-A coupons, and you had never eaten Chick-fil-A, but you didn't have a way to go get it. And I'm like, you know what? You don't have to worry about it. I'm going to bring it to you. And Webby and I came over
That's right.
and brought you some Chick-fil-A. And we just had a feast right there.
Yes, we did.
Yes, we did. So anyway, but God bless you. And just know, you know, I've given everybody my cell number, and you know how to get in touch with me if you need me, okay? All right.
Okay, yeah, sure will.
All right. You just remember that I love you and God loves you. All right. We're getting your car fixed. We're getting your car fixed. All right.
All right.
All right. You hang in there, sweetheart.
I will. I am.
All right.
And I'm going to keep you on my prayers, you and Webby both.
All right.
Oh, thank you, Mary. I need it because I live with her.
Oh, yes, I know. He needs lots of prayers. That's right. Well, Mary, we'll come and break some Chick-fil-A bread together again soon. All right, sweetie?
Okay.
All right. Love you. All right. Bye-bye.
Love you. Goodbye.
All right. You know, it's a farewell day to JAJ today on WFIA. If you'd like to call, 571-2428, 571-CHAT. I appreciate all I appreciate the wonderful comments. And of course, you know, that's when we opened the song, it was like, I don't mind if you have something nice to say about me. It's just, it's really, really nice to hear. And thank you so much. But again, Tom Mitchell and Ann is here. Ann called in the first hour and she's still shaken, by the way.
Yeah.
she's not real happy about the whole deal. But anyway, but Tom came in. Tom, you and I had some really good shows together.
We definitely did. I miss doing radio.
I know. Yeah. I bet you do. Mm-hmm. Well, I think radio misses you.
It's shit. Well, I'd come back in a heartbeat if that door opened for me.
Yeah. You like it that much?
I do. Yeah. I definitely do.
It's a fun field. It's a rocky field, though, as you well know. You know, it's up and down, and you never know. So buyouts happen, and it happened.
And Dave been warning me that since it's the first day I walked in here. This is my first job when I moved here from California about 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Dave always warned me. It's like, you know, you never know. It could be sold in the following week.
Yep.
And well, I stayed for 8 years, and it never happened.
Yep. Well, it has now, so, you know, that's just kind of the way it is. But, yeah, it's kind of like a bank merger, you know. It's like, that's what happens, you know. I mean, my bank just got bought out, and I walked in one day, and they had all the signs were different. I'm like, what just happened?
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway, but it happens, and, you know, God has plans. I don't know what they are. But
well, like I said during the break, it's like it's not a good thing. It's not a bad thing. It's just a thing.
It is.
You know,
you could always count on Tom to come up with something really profound like that, you know. That's what I love that.
Well, he and Mark Twain.
You know, if God was calling in right now, I think he would say, well done, good and faithful servant, but I've opened a door for you someplace else, and now it's time for you to look for it.
All right.
There you go.
Well, thanks, Tom. I appreciate that. And I'm gonna be looking for it, because I can tell you know, it's got a knock on my door. And I'm just like, now, what next, Lord? I mean,
well, if you get too comfortable, he pulls a chair out from under you.
That's right.
I've had that happen a time or two before as well, so I know how that is. But anyway, I don't know if we have a caller. I think Gary's talking to somebody. But listen, I am giving away books today again. If you have always intended to get one of these books, make sure that you get yours today, because I'm giving them away. 502-571-2428, 571-CHAT. And you can call and get your name, and I'll call you back and get your address. I'll chat with you a little bit. That's just kind of my genre. It's what I've always done. So I appreciate that. And I have gotten to know a lot of you via phone because, you know, I usually sit at night and call. And when I'm giving away things, I always love to give away things. And, you know, so I appreciate you allowing me to do that. I laughed, Tom, because, you know, Rush Limbaugh was giving away, you know, iPhones and all kinds of like that. And I'm like, okay, so, you know, I'm giving away, but it's not like Rush Limbaugh. I don't quite have the budget that Rush Limbaugh does, but, you know, so, nor the contacts.
There's nothing wrong with Chick-fil-A.
Hey, no. That's right. I gave away Chick-fil-A. I gave away Starbucks and Panera. People loved it, you
know. Practical.
So I'm like, but hey, it came out of my pocket, you know, so that's what I could do. Marcy, thank you so much for calling in.
Hey, Mom.
Well, that's Marcy Mom.
Marcy Mom. Hey, Marce.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, Marcy.
I just wanted to call and tell you that me and my family are very proud of you for everything that you've done there and for all the people that you've helped, because I don't think people understand how much really that you do for others and how much time that you spend trying to help people through problems. And you don't ever ask for, you know, any kind of payment or anything for people, for you to spend hours counseling people when other counselors would charge them hundreds of dollars to, you know,
sit there and listen to them, and you just do it because you are a good Christian woman, and because you have a heart for helping people and their relationships, and it's just a great testament to
Thank
how you,
baby. You
and Dad have just really been your whole lives with All helping right. people.
Got to go to a break.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Could your skin use a little lift without surgery? That invasive process? Well, why not try About Face Spa and Salon? If you have a problem area, Tia can specify the protocol to target those trouble areas, whether it's laugh lines, rosacea, acne, sagging neck and jowls, eye lifting techniques, whatever you need, she can do. Call her and get an appointment today, 812-288-2300. Tell her Just Ask Joy sent you and get a discount.
I've heard that when one is having a difficult conversation with another person, the best way to get them to listen to reason is to season your words with a bit of flattery. Now, I'm all for showering others with praise when it is appropriate and well-deserved, but I would not recommend flattery as a means to an end. However, I would recommend what Paul suggested in the book of Colossians: season your speech with the salt of grace, and not just a little. Graceful and kind words will go a long way toward helping two people find the common ground they're searching for. And this is David Jeremiah, encouraging you to get on the road to new life. Discover God's gracious words on Route 66.
Route 66, driving the word home. Log on to Route66Life.com and get your roadmap for life. That's Route66Life.com. Route 66, start your journey home today.
Salvation is of the Lord. He's the one who brings people to himself. But amazingly, God uses people in this supernatural process. I'm Ron Moore with today's Bible Minute. In Romans chapter 10, verses 14 and 15, Paul reminds us of this amazing privilege. How then can they call on the one they've not believed in? And how can they believe in the one they've not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can they preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. And we have the privilege of carrying and proclaiming the message of salvation. God then works in the heart of the hearer to understand the good news and trust in Jesus alone as the only way to have a relationship with the living God. But we get to partner with God in His work of eternal salvation. Find out more at backtothebible.org.
The real estate market is hot right now. Are you thinking of buying or selling your home in this market? Do you have any questions about preparing your home to sell? Are you even thinking about real estate investing? Do you have questions about financing a piece of property, or should you refinance your current home? Let me assist you in all of your real estate needs. Hire the hardest working real estate agent you'll ever meet, Elizabeth Monarch with Keller Williams Louisville. When the time comes to making that important decision of buying or selling your home, call me. I want to be your realtor. Search for All Homes at ElizabethMonarchGroup.com. Like me on Facebook. That's Elizabeth Monarch with Keller Williams Louisville at 502-551-1286. ElizabethMonarchGroup.com, the hardest working real estate agent you'll ever meet.
I'm Jonna Cruz. Join Keith Stevens and me this weekend for Keep the Faith.
Old family videos can be good for a laugh, but our friend Amy Grant has come away with something more.
He's between these two worlds. Like, he's looking at his grandchildren, but then he kept returning to his mother's face. You know, something sort of tender and beautiful and sad.
I hope you can join us for Keep the Faith.
Keep the Faith, Saturday night at midnight on WFIA, The Spirit.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for listening today. It is a farewell day on JAJ, on FIA. I will be around justaskjoyce.com, or check me out on Facebook, the Just Ask Joyce page, or follow me on Twitter. Or you have my cell number. I've given it all to you, 812-989-8175. You can check that out on my website. Remember, Webby and I will be doing a Valentine's special on February the 10th, Romance in the Rock, More Than a Dream. I encourage you to go to marriageatmercywithi.org and, hey, get some tickets.
Register.
And, see us. And we were talking to my daughter, Marcy. It was very sweet. You know, and I didn't want her to quit, but we had to go to a break. But thanks, Marcy, for those sweet words. I appreciate that very much.
Well, you're welcome. And, you know, just we made it for you because we know how much you it means to you to be able to help people and have that means of doing it. But you've always helped people your whole life, and that's not going to stop just because this is happening. Right. So you definitely persevere, Mom.
Your kids have been introduced to the world, too. Booker and George have been on the station a lot.
I go in public, it's like, oh, you're Booker's Mimi. It's not, you're just S. Joyce, you're Booker's Mimi, or you're George's Mimi. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, they wanted to try to be on with you, but they were going to a movie today, and so I don't know if it's going to work out that they'll be back in time.
That's
to call,
okay.
We had them at Christmas.
They hate
it.
Was
good. Yeah. I know, they do. They do, but they have loved it. But anyway, thanks so much, sweetheart. Love you.
No, love you guys, too.
Love you, Marcy.
Bye.
And we have Catherine on the line. Hi, Catherine. How are you?
Joyce, I'm just so fine. How are you?
I'm good,
and
darling.
And Webby.
Yeah,
and
I'm doing good.
Sweet to take my call. I'm so sorry we're not going to hear your sweet voice anymore. I can't stand it.
Well,
as a listener, I'll tell you, I am.
Well, thank you so much. I appreciate that. I know it's you know, it's been a part of my life for so long, it just felt like it was going to go on forever, but, you know. Sometimes
you walk that straight path, now you're at the corner. All you got to do is turn, Joyce.
That's
there
right.
must be something great around it.
Well, I'm sure there is. I'm just going to have to be patient and listen to the Lord and figure it out along the way. But, you know, he'll either, like Tom
Always.
Said, you know, he may yank the chair out from under me and wake me up.
I doubt that.
But we'll,
I doubt that.
We'll figure it out.
He has other plans, big or small.
You keep up with me, sweetheart. And
you
thank
know
you
it.
So much
right.
for calling.
He took my number. I was interested in the books, and
great.
He took my number. Is that all I needed to give him?
That was it.
That's it. And I'll give you a call and get your address. God bless you.
You are
so
all
much.
In our prayers.
Thank
you too, and happy new year.
Thank you. You
and
too, darling.
God bless.
Thank you. Karen, thank you so much for calling.
Hello.
Hey, Karen.
I'm so disappointed that you're not going to be on the air anymore. I have enjoyed your show so much.
Well, thank you so much. I've enjoyed being a part of your life, and I don't know how long you've been listening, but, you know, I really appreciate you being faithful and you know, and keeping up with me, and you know, and I hope that you got some of my books. Did you?
No, but
you make sure you
one
give
you said about grandma's.
Oh, yep. You'll enjoy that one. So make sure Gary gets your number before you hang up, and I'll make sure you get one in the mail. But then we'll have to agree to get a cup of coffee and talk about it.
Okay.
All right. And I made that promise to everybody that reads Grandma's Jewels, and I would love to sit and talk to you guys about that or any book or just about anything. So, but anyway, thank you so much, Karen. I appreciate it, darling, more than you know.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
You have a great new year. All right.
Tom, who was that said when you come to a fork in the road, take it? Well, was that Yogi Berra? It sounds like one of his.
It does sound like something he would say.
If you don't know who Tom is, many of you will remember that Tom was my first producer.
Yeah.
And, you know, he rolled the first show of Just Ask Joyce. And that was pretty cool. That was Sundays, you know. Mm-hmm. When I started out, I was just going to be a Sunday show. And then immediately it worked into a Monday through Friday show.
He loved you. He loved you.
It was pretty cool. But anyway, so I thought we had a caller, but maybe they hung up. But anyway, I think somebody is getting some books. But again, I am giving away books, 571-2428. If you'd like one of my books, please call Gary and just give him that information, and we'll take it from there, all right? So just make sure that you do. I know the phones are ringing, and y'all just be patient. We only have a little bit of time left. These are the last minutes now of the Just Ask Joy show on WFIA. If you are unsure about what we're talking about, of course, new ownership has taken over, and they do not have me in their plans. And so I will be moving on. I don't know where, but God will show me. I've always listened to him. And if you came to my Christmas tea, you know, I spoke about the guiding light. And he always will give you the light. You just have to kind of look for it and be still sometimes. And I plan to do a little bit of that, but you know, I will be moving on. We have a caller on hold, perhaps, and you call 571-2428, 571-CHAT, and I'm going to give you my cell phone number now, right now, 812-989-8175. If you need your Family Life Fix-It Pro, I will be available from here on out. Don't go away. We'll be back just another few minutes with Just Ask Joyce.
WFIA, The Spirit.
Inspiration. Every word counts. This is Ken Ham, heading up the ministry building a full-size Noah's Ark near Cincinnati. Scripture begins with the account of creation in the book of Genesis. Now we know that because God cannot lie, we can trust what Genesis says about origins. But God didn't write the Bible directly. So who did? Well, the first five books of the Bible were written by Moses. We sometimes call these the books of Moses. He knew about the creation of the universe and man because God revealed it to him. We call this inspiration. In fact, the whole Bible is inspired. You see, the Apostle Paul tells us that the Scriptures were breathed out by God. The Holy Spirit divinely guided the authors of the Bible in their writing, so we have an accurate and authoritative account, beginning with Genesis.
Discover more about the history of the Bible as you visit our award-winning website, answersingenesis.org. Go to answersingenesis.org.
Sometimes we take our own spiritual temperature and come away thinking, I'm doing fine. But Dr. Tony Evans says it often takes more probing and prodding to find out how healthy our faith really is. More on that today as we spend 2 minutes with Tony.
It's coming up on my annual physical review, and in my annual physical review, I'm going to have to take a stress test, which means the doctor's going to put me on a treadmill with all these attachments on my chest, and he's going to be reading a sheet as I walk to determine the condition of my heart. He's not going to take my word that I think my heart's okay. He's not going to buy it because I feel like my heart's okay. He's going to ask me how I'm doing. How's my heart? I'm going to say my heart's fine. And he's going to say, prove it. Let's put you under some stress. So I'm going to get on the treadmill and I'm going to walk. And that treadmill's going to climb and incline and keep inclining until I'm huffing and puffing. Until I can't take it no more. Until I throw in the towel. Then he's going to look at his paper and he's going to tell me what my heart is. We may be here this morning and think our spiritual hearts are fine. Do all the things that we're told to do or led to do in song and in ceremony because we think our heart is okay. But God is saying this is a test. And you always know a test because it's adversity. It's never pleasant, never preferred, never requested, yet it is inescapable because God allows it.
Dr. Evans has an extensive collection of messages online, something to speak to any need. Browse our library today by visiting tonyevans.org. And be sure to join us next time for 2 Minutes with Tony.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Thank you so much for joining us. It is a farewell day on JAJ as far as FIA goes. But I am not saying farewell forever. I'm going to be on my website. I'm going to be on Facebook. You make sure that you keep up with me because, you know, God's not through with me yet, and we'll just see what he has in store. But in the meantime, you know, I always like that phrase. In the meantime, you can contact me at all times to be your Family Life Fix-It Pro. I am still going to be out there doing that. I will still be helping you. I have given you my cell number. I'm going to give it again, 812-989-8175. It is on my website. Remember that Webby and I are doing a marriage Valentine's dinner. It's going to be a presentation, Romance in the Rock, More Than a Dream. It's going to be awesome. You're going to love it. You come and enjoy it with us. Go to marriage@mercy.org, and mercy is spelled with an I. Okay, so make sure that you spell it correctly or you won't find it. marriage@mercy.org. And if you can't find it, then you write me at justaskjoyce@gmail.com and I'll get you there. All right, Francis, thank you so much for calling in today.
Hello. Hello, Joyce.
How are you?
Hey.
Hey, I hear you talked to my better half earlier.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, John.
I did. I know.
He
got a little choked up. I know. Bless his heart. You guys have been, you guys were one of the first listeners and loyal callers for, you know, for a while. And I love that. We fell in love with you and we had to meet you. You came out to meet us one day when I had a remote.
Yes.
Tom Mitchell was there. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yep.
You both have been such a blessing to John and I and our family more than probably you ever know.
Well, thank you.
And, I'm sorry that you're going off the air, but I know you, Joyce, and this is not a first, nor will it be a last.
That's right. That's right. Well, you know, I made a promise to God a long time ago, and he's still holding me to it, let me tell you. So I don't think he's going to let me off the hook until Judgment Day. So we'll keep at it. So, but God bless you. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
I know there's reasons, and you know as well as I do, and all of God's people, that, and he tells us in Romans 8, that all things work together for good to them that love God, to those that are called according to his purpose.
Amen.
And that's what we have to stand on and walk in and, you know, come what may.
That's right. I shall.
Yes, I know God, you will. But you know the blessings that you have been to our family on radio and off. So your life is an example all the time.
Thank you.
We really do appreciate you guys.
Thank you so much.
So I'm sorry I won't be able to hear you on the radio every day, even though I don't call in faithfully.
Well, you know, like I said, I might be doing some podcasting or maybe some television. I think you'll be hearing or seeing me somewhere, right?
Okay.
So God bless you.
We will be keeping in touch.
All right, darling. You keep my number and keep in touch. All right.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Francis.
We love you guys.
We love you too.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
God bless. All right. And we are giving away books today still, if you'd like some of Joyce's books. I'm only giving away two, Keeping His Pants On Until He Gets Home, Turning Her On, and Keeping, and Grandma's Jewels. It's just kind of hand in glove,
you know.
They need to go together. But you can get Turning Her On and Keeping Her Heart on my website, Just Ask Joyce. Paula, thank you so much for calling in.
Hi, Joyce. God bless you, you precious soul. I'm going to miss hearing you on the radio. You've been more than a godsend.
Aww.
Thank you. Thank you for everything you've said, done. The heck has not been told that you've done for us.
Aww.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. God bless you, and I will miss all of you, too.
Oh, God, and you too, Webby.
Thank you very much, Paul.
I followed you guys to different venues. I'm at the South Louisville Church.
Yeah, that's right.
You were there, and I just love you guys so
much. Thank you so much.
We hope to see more of you, Paula. God bless you.
Right. Bye-bye. Happy New Year.
And to you. Mike, thank you so much for calling.
Hi, how you doing, Joyce?
We're doing good, Mike.
Hi, Webby.
Yeah,
how are you?
Hey, Michael, how's it going, buddy?
Yeah.
I'm doing all right.
Is that that ankle healed up?
Oh my! The ankle, it's getting better. It's
good.
Getting better.
Good, good. We've been praying for you, buddy.
I know you have, and that's why I wanted to call in. And I just wanted to let the listeners know I'm Michael McDonald, and I'm a combat veteran. And I just want to say how much that Joyce, you, and Webby, and also the Christian community out there, all your listeners have made such an impact on my life and my children's lives. I know, you know, we've done some donation things, and Pastor Webby took me as me and Joyce have talked several times, and Pastor Webby is took me to the hospital when I had to have surgery and a plate and screws inserted in my foot, and I had nobody to take me, and they stepped up to the plate, as well as, you know, all your listeners, Joyce, this whole Christian community. I just want to say what an impact you have made, and it's just, you're going to be so missed.
Well, thank you, Michael. Appreciate it so much. And, you know, our listeners prayed for you, and our listeners did step up. That's what I love about this audience. And, you know, they're like God.
Yes, ma'am.
They show up, you know, just in the nick of time, and they help. And they've always been that kind of audience that has responded to a need. They know that I'm not going to present them a need that's bogus or something that, you know, is not legit. And so I've appreciated what they do on behalf of the Lord. And we're going to keep praying for you. We appreciate your service to our country. And we know that you are in the predicament that you have been in because of your service to our country. And I believe that we all owe you guys a great indebtedness that we will never be able to repay. So God bless you, and thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much for saying that, Joyce. A lot of people don't say that, and that just means a lot to me. And I hope what I've said to you and Webby has meant a lot, and as well as this station has meant, how much it's meant to me just listening to it and what an impact it's made to me. And my mother got me listening to it originally, and I just couldn't stop after that. It was every day.
You have a blessed new year, man.
Well, God makes no mistakes about networking, so she networked you just right. You know, he used her to get to us, so there you go. But God
That's
bless
right.
you. You have a great new year, and I'm praying that it's going to turn around for you, Michael. All right.
Thank you. And you guys keep in touch, okay?
All right. Yeah, and same here. All right. God
love
you.
Love,
all right.
God love bless you,
too.
You guys. I love you.
All right. Love you, too. Bye-bye. You see, guys, this I love this because you're hearing from people that you have helped. You know, it's not just me or Webby. It's you. You guys have helped. And, you know, our 50th anniversary, you know, I'm like, okay, so WFIA is still going to be here. They're still going to keep, I think, these call letters. But, you know, we celebrated our 50th anniversary this year. And you know, I've already talked about, you know, on that show, we'll talk about to Paul Jacobs about that. And, you know, but again, you know, that's what we do in this community. We have stepped up. We have helped so many people.
Yep.
As, you know, just in partnership with God. And just as Joyce was just an extension of Jesus, that's what I have tried to convey to you. And you have helped me. It's not just been me, it's been you. Because I could not have accomplished anything that God wanted to accomplish through me without you. So you know that. And we are going into our final break. And when we come back, it is the end of Just Ask Joyce, as we know it on WFIA. But not the end of Just Ask Joyce. Remember, justaskjoyce.com. You can keep up with me right there, and I will be back.
WFIA, The Spirit.
When's the right time to take on codependency? What about depression, anxiety, and grief? You see, Valley View Church's Celebrate Recovery is more than just a 12-step recovery program for alcohol and chemical addiction. It's a meal, testimony, and support through accountability. Celebrate Recovery breaks down into smaller groups by gender while we work through life's hurts, habits, and hang-ups. And yes, there's childcare here, too. Join us Thursday evenings at Valley View, and let's tackle a problem or two. Visit vvchurch.org.
Warning, do not drink milk while watching the hilarious clean comedy videos at GodTube.com. Extended viewing of Safe for the Family comedy at GodTube.com from Christian comedians like Tim Hawkins, Anita Renfro, Bob Smiley, and more may lead to crippling side effects such as watery eyes, runny nose, and a bright red face. At GodTube.com, non-offensive, good, clean humor leads to giggles, guffaws, and howls. Some even experience ROFL. Rolling on the floor laughing. GodTube.com may be habit-forming. That's GodTube.com. I'm not kidding. GodTube.com.
Choosing the right school for your child can be one of the most important and difficult decisions you can make. WFIA wants to help make that decision a little easier by inviting parents and guardians to attend the 4th Annual School Expo at the Mall St. Matthews on Saturday, January 14th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. The expo will feature local, private, and independent schools. Take advantage of this opportunity to talk with representatives from some of Louisville's top schools. Explore the variety of faith-based and independent private schools, interactive displays, all in one convenient location. WFIA, along with sponsors Class Act Federal Credit Union and Black Diamond Pest Control, look forward to seeing you at the Mall St. Matthews, Saturday, January 14th, starting at 10 a.m. For more information on participating schools and sponsors, visit our website at WFIAFM.com and click on the School Expo banner. And if your school would like to participate, contact Stephanie at 502-423-3135.
You're listening to Just Ask Joyce on WFIA, The Spirit.
Oh, didn't know I was back on and I'm wasting my time. Jolinda, we've got a little bit of time. Thanks for calling, sweetheart.
I called the first hour, but I couldn't get through it. So.
That's all right.
I said, Gary, maybe I can compose myself for the second hour.
Aw.
I just want to tell you how much you mean to me.
Aw. Thank you, sweetie.
And I didn't meet you. Some people say they knew you from long ago. I didn't meet you until Chip Ingram was in Louisville.
Yes.
I don't remember what. When was that? A year ago?
Yeah.
Year ago.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. And I met you, and it was like a sister bonded. It was wonderful.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much. It has been a pleasure getting to know you, too. And you've been very supportive of anything that I've done. You've shown up at teas and other things. And thank you so much. You are a friend, indeed.
Yes.
And we will not. This is not the end of me and you. So
that's exactly
that's
right.
That's right. So, God bless
you. And one day you're going to look up and I'm going to be sitting in that church service.
Hey, come on, girl. Come on.
It's 1130 Dale Avenue, Lincoln Hills Christian Church. If y'all want to come out, you come out. God
I
bless you.
I will be there. I'm going to surprise you, though. I probably won't tell you ahead of time.
All right, darling. Love you. Thank you so much.
Love you, and you be blessed.
All right, you too. And Alan, thank you for calling in.
Hey, just what the heck's going on? You know, I know you'll be okay, but it's kind of frustrating. I was like, does these people even know what the heck they're doing? I mean, I guess they're out for the almighty buck. I don't know, but me and my wife listened to you for quite a while, and she got me listening to you more and more, and I usually don't call in and talk to people a lot and stuff like that, but yeah, I just had to call in and tell you that best wishes and everything's going to work out.
Well, Alan, thank you. That
yeah,
means
thank
a lot,
you, Alan,
to,
so
lot
much.
To me. And we just have to trust God with all of this and know that,
you know, a corporate decision.
Corporate decision. And I respect that. You know, they have their own vision, and it's not, you know, I'm not part of that, but I am part of God's vision. And so we just have to keep that in mind. And thank you so much for listening. Thank you for calling in. I really appreciate that.
Yeah,
I know that took a
great.
Lot for you to do that, but God bless you.
Thank you for being there.
Thank you. And y'all just know that y'all can still get in touch with me. If you don't do internet, you certainly have my cell phone number, and I'm going to give it to you one more time, guys. But thank you so much, Alan. All right, God bless. And you tell your wife a big hello, too. Here's the phone number, guys, 812-989-8175. That is my cell number. You put it in your contacts as JAJ, Just Ask Joyce. And there is no other, all right? I know there might be just Joyce Meyer. She might even show up on the air. I don't know. But there's only one Just Ask Joyce for you, your Family Life Fix-It Pro. And, you know, I have the heart for this community. I have been here. I will continue to be here for you. And I appreciate everybody that's gotten me, you know, through this, like Tom Mitchell, Gary Clark. Of course, you know, you've been hearing the voice of Gary with me. And, Gary, God bless you, and thank you so much for being here, and it's been a pleasure, you know, working with you as well. And I'm going to miss you, but I know you're going to be around still a little bit. But
I'm still going to be here, but I'm going to miss you too, and I'll miss our little road trips that we took, to the Ark Experience.
I know it was
a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, and the teas were fun too.
Yep, we had a lot of good times, and of course Tom Mitchell, I appreciate you, and you have no idea how important, how much it meant for you and Robin to show up today.
Yeah.
I mean, that was just
great.
It was
surprise.
So unexpected and just a blessing. And Anne, thank you so much for coming by. I mean, she called in, but it wasn't enough. That wasn't enough for her. She just showed up. She showed up. And, you know, that was just, and I know that many others of you would have if you had had prior notice, and maybe you lived as close as Anne. She was 10 minutes away. But, you know, I just want to, again, just to say thank you for how much you have meant to me. For the support and the loyalty. And I know that many prayers have gone out for me and on my behalf many times. And, you know, I prayed all the time before I ever went on microphone. I always bathed it in prayer and never took lightly what God tasked me to do on WFIA. Never took lightly. And if I ever wasted your airtime, you know, I apologize, but I'm really more accountable to God than I am you. So I did not take lightly what I do here. And again, you know, I think maybe December might not would have been so light, but maybe it was by design.
Oh, it was good. We got to hear Gary sing Christmas carols.
Yep.
I don't know if I'd consider that a highlight.
I was Porky listening to the show, too.
You were listening
I heard it.
Porky Pig was a highlight.
Oh, all the animals.
Blue, blue, blue,
we've
blue,
had
blue,
some
blue
good
Christmas.
Times. We've had some sad times, you know. We've helped a lot of people. Thank you so much for what you have meant to me. And I really didn't want to get to this point where I might just have difficulty saying goodbye. But again, you have my numbers. JustAskJoyce.com is how you can keep in touch with me. I will still be doing what God has asked me to do, and that is, of course, to stay in battle for His cause.
The Spirit, 94.7 WFIA FM, New Albany, Louisville, is a service of Salem Media Group, online at WFIAFM.com. Focus on the Family is sponsored by Focus on the Family on WFIA The Spirit.